Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. Mic check, we got about 2 minutes before we go live. Doing a little audio check, gonna do a little chat check. Let me know how it sounds out there. Doing something a little bit different this stream. Explain the details once we actually kick over to Facecam. Check, okay, check complete. That's right, you hear me loud and clear, 5x5. Groove. Check. Check, check, 1, 2, check. Sticky keys. No sticky keys. You may be hearing another ping sound in the background because we are currently streaming to multiple platforms. Wave of the future. There you go, mic check, Groove. Welcome back. Glad you can hear me. DJA, thank you for the host. The future is now. That is correct. We got less than a minute before we go live. Wanted to do an audio check, sound check, chat check. DJA, yeah, nice female voice. You're silly. So silly. Tarantley, welcome back. Hopefully you'll be able to stick around in the stream. You have to take off with the last one. Showtime is now, so we're going to go ahead. Take into my options. I'm going to leave the music as it is and kick it over to live screen. Welcome to the Roller Coaster Tycoon channel. Or welcome back if you were here earlier. We streamed earlier today for the specific reason of launching a contest. We are running a global contest, and I'm actually going to go through and bring my audio down just a little bit. This way you guys can hear me clearly. Yes, me again. Biba. We launched a contest earlier for park creation. Essentially, global contest to ask all of our users to have a creative vision, so to speak. Essentially, I'm going to go through the details of the contest here again for those of you that missed it. But before I do, they are actually up over on, you can see them on our forums. There's an actual webpage up for them, and I'm going to put the official rules out in the chat right now for everybody to see. This way, if you have any questions, you can go directly over and check them out. Essentially what it is we have a month-long contest where we are asking users to create their coolest park using all the coasters and stalls and shops and rides and scenery and shrubberies and benches and anything you could possibly use, including UGC. One quick disclaimer I'll make about the UGC, be sure to check stuff that's copywritten, trademarked, or could be possibly illegal or some terms. It's all noted in the official rules that I linked out in chat, so... essentially, there are five categories for this month-long contest. There is one that's open, that is essentially free reign. You can use anything you want in terms of content. You can use UGC. There's no specific format. Essentially, what we're looking for is three specific judging criteria, and these three criteria are also going to apply to these other categories that I'm going to talk about here in just a moment. We're looking for creativity and style, originality in presentation, and attention to detail. Now for the open category, that's all we're going to be looking at, right? So the more attention to detail you have in there, and originality, etc., It's going to earn you greater marks when we go through and collect all the entries and start judging them. There are four other categories, and they are essentially region-specific. The first one is the United States category. That's New York City Central Park, and that's kind of what I'm going to be going, not kind of, that's actually what I'm going to be going through and showing you. I was working on a park in the last stream, specifically the northeast corner of Central Park, reinterpreting what I think it looks like through Roller Coaster Tycoon World. So again, those three criteria of creativity and style, originality and presentation, and attention to detail, sounds more than three, but essentially they're grouped that way. We're also looking for local references for Central Park, and I'll explain the one for Central Park in more detail when I show it. But the other categories, for example, the next one up is United Kingdom. We're going to be using Hyde Park as your references, so something iconic, something special from Hyde Park that you want to go ahead and try and recreate in the game, please do. We're going to be looking for that stuff. That actual criteria is, if you're going to enter that specific category, that criteria is mandatory. So if somebody enters something for Hyde Park and they have no references for Hyde Park, it's not going to be considered. If you have something with no references at all, then put it towards the open category. The next two are Netherlands and Germany. So for the Netherlands, there's Vondelpark. Any references you can use from that specific park are going to be within the criteria for that category of the Netherlands. And then for the German category, there's the English Gardens. So any of the references you can think of, and I'm talking land masses, like if there's a pond or a lake or if something specifically man-made, like a fountain or a statue or an archway, anything that you can think of, be creative. I mean, really is what it comes down to. Creativity and style, right? This is your own creative interpretation of those categories, essentially, the open one being open, as it said. So it's going to run for an entire month. Essentially, the actual duration is going to open today. So essentially, if you had something saved and you want to go put it into the open category, you can go submit it right now. What you want to do is you want to create a video of fly through, fly over, whatever the park, no longer than 3 minutes. Save that video to a YouTube channel or wherever the case may be and send it to streamers@rollercoastertycoon.com. And I'm actually going to grab that email address and put it into channel here momentarily. I'm actually going to type it, just type it in. Did I spell it correctly? I think I did. Let's go ahead and there. Now it's spelled correctly. So now you have the email address that we're going to be using. Jordan, nice. Doubling up on the posting there. Love the mod. Nah, no crumbs. You got it. Love the assistance, man. Appreciate you sitting in on the channel to mod too. So essentially, that's where you're going to send the video. No more than 3 minutes. We want to keep them to a short amount so we can actually collect them all and judge all the entries in an orderly fashion when they all come in. And essentially, it's going to close at the end of June, the 26th. Let me just confirm. I have my notes over here on the left. Yes, June 26th is when it's going to end. So at 11:59 p.m. on June 26th, the contest is going to end. We are going to announce the winner about a week after the entries close. July 5th specifically. We were going to do the 4th, but the 4th here is a U.S. holiday. A lot of our offices are closed. It's a bank holiday, so we're not going to be open, so we extended it 1 day past on the Tuesday after to go ahead and announce the actual winner. Now, it may take longer, and we say in the official rules it's on or about approximately on the 5th, just in case we get overwhelmed with entries and we need some extra time. So that's going to run, like I said, the entire month, and I'll show you. I've basically done a couple of hours on this park, not too crazy, that I'm going through that. I'm going to show you a little bit and see why it's going to be an entire month long. It's going to be crazy. But the actual meat and potatoes of the contest, surprises, what are you guys going to win, right? What are you getting? Again, all over on the official rules, but there are going to be four winners for each of the five categories. So essentially, we're going to have 20 winners in total, right? Out of each category, you're going to have a grand prize winner, first runner-up, second runner-up, and a third runner-up. Now, the grand prize... Okay, first and foremost, let me back it up just a little bit. All the winners are going to get one of these. RCW t-shirt right here. Going to get one of these. But the actual big prize is grand prize is going to get a $200 Amazon gift card. First prize runner-ups are going to get a $100 Amazon gift card. Second prize runner-ups are going to get $50 Amazon gift cards. And third prize runner-ups are going to get $25 Amazon gift cards. So those are the prizes that we're going to be giving out. And this is just the beginning. There's more to come. I've been telling you guys, if you've been following the streams and you've been listening to me, if you know me and message me and talk to me offline, off stream, it's really, there's more to come. For those that didn't make it to the stream this morning, I actually had a really unique idea of to do an actual live walkthrough of this piece of park that I'm building here for Central Park. And I got some really good feedback in terms of people liking the idea. So there's a really good chance that I'm going to do that. The logistics of it need to be figured out. I haven't even thought beyond doing it. So that's something we're going to have to think about. And I'm going to go scroll chat real quick to see if there's any questions. And then I'm not going to bore you anymore with any chat. If you do have any questions, message me over on our forums. You can message me there. If you see me on Steam and you friend of me on Steam, you can message me there. Message me here as well. Wherever you can get a hold of me, send me to Facebook. I mean, you want to shout out on Twitter. You have a question, you want to DM the Twitter account, that's fine. I manage that pretty heavily. And it's going to be more active going forward. So definitely stay tuned to that. And again, multiple modes of communication going on here today. So you're going to see my head back and forth all over the place. One of the reasons why is because it is it's a U.S. holiday this weekend, too. It's Memorial Day. So our office is closed Monday. A lot of other offices around the country are closed as well. So close all this stuff out here. Okay. So looking at those, like I said, I want to scroll chat really quick to see if there are any questions here. Yeah, Beaker just started, so you're in on the front end. Good to see you. Yeah, JMR, yes. I want you to add anything you want. Everything you want. Stalls, shops, scenery, UGC, coasters, rides, everything. It's not just... Don't think of it as a recreation of whatever park you choose, that whatever category you want to enter. Think of it as a creative vision. And I'm going to go through the piece of Central Park that I'm working on here. Obviously, I'm not eligible, so I'm not going to enter. But I'm actually doing this more like an inspirational thing, and it's going to flow into the Sandbox and Chill. For those of you that follow and sit in on the dev streams as well as the Sandbox and Chill, this is going to be... Sandbox and Chill, if I say it one more time, I'm going to get sick of it, throughout the rest of the month. So when I sit down and don't have any updates for you guys, this is what I'm going to be working on. Kind of like a motivational stream. Say, hey, you know what? I'm still working on mine. How you guys doing on yours? Get some feedback of what's going on. Really excited to see with the landmarks we've picked that some of the creative references are going to be used in the streams that are coming out. The content that's going to be coming through. Yeah, Death Dome. I'm not recreating the entire... Okay, all right. Let's do this. You ready? Game is up. Here, first and foremost, this is what I'm going to do. I'm actually going to pull up Google Maps right now because that's what I got working. You'll see I have it over here on this side. See it over there? Just a minute. This is what I'm looking at, right? Central Park is huge, right? So I'm looking at this specific piece here, and I'm turning off the audio because the music right now is just killing my head. So... You see Harlem Mir, okay? This specific piece of the park right here, and I'll zoom out real quick. Central Park is huge. It spans many, 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 many city blocks here in New York City. So you see if I zoom all the way out, this is Manhattan, New York. Got Manhattan right here, island, connected by all these lovely bridges and tunnels. But if you zoom in, I selected the park corner up here in the top right, essentially the northeast corner, because it's not too detailed, but it's not too bland. There's a bunch of paths that come through. There's some different path sizes, which is one of the reasons you'll see here in a minute as I go through. And as we're looking at the map, I'm going to load it up in the back end because it'll probably take a minute too. But essentially going through and trying to get a general layout, which I have a good chunk of. I still have to work on it a little bit. It's really a creative revision, if you will. Imagineering, somebody said in chat that I saw. And I want to go through it. It's not an exact recreation. It really is just my vision of what I want to build. I want to be creative. I don't want to recreate the thing piece by piece. I'd be here forever, as Death Tone would say. You know, Central Park is huge. So I'm taking a small piece of it, and I'm looking to make it fancy. I'm going to put my own little bit of jazz on it, so to speak, right? All right, so now, here, the game is up. I'm going to pull it over just another minute here. So let's get a good view, kind of like a perspective thing, so you can see what it looks like. I'm using just a specific little lake right here that we're looking at in the actual Google Maps, right? So here, you can see the lake, right? You can see it, Harlem Mir, looks okay, right? So now we're going to pull it out, get rid of maps, and pull into the game, right? Look at that. See that? Map, game. Map, game. Not exact, but enough of a replica to bring the reference. You know, I keep talking about this reference to the actual park itself, right? It's something that I can take and look and easily identify. So if someone were to take and use this specific park to enter into the contest, they would put the subject line for United States. And I would open it up and see it, take a look at the video, and immediately see, oh, that's Harlem Mir from Central Park. That's great. And then I would zoom in, start looking at all the detail. And believe it or not, there's not a whole lot out here right now. But I started going through on the last stream, and basically I had, you can see the paths coming in here from the top, right? It's kind of like a, it's not really a service road, so to speak. It's kind of like, I really don't know another way to put it, but kind of like an abandoned service road where the park servicemen will come through if they need to in their trucks to clean everything up, but it's not open to outside traffic. And then you'll see the smaller paths on the side are actually walking paths and or biking paths throughout the city. And all I did was I created, before the stream, I actually created the lake itself. And then I started putting in just this little piece up here of paths of actually coming down off to the left and off to the right. And what I'm going to do on this stream is I'm going to continue to work on it. If you notice, I'll bring the actual map back up. If you notice over here, I'll zoom in. There's some other paths that come. You see Nutter's Battery, Fort Clinton. There's a couple of other different things in here. And you see, I'm going to try and connect all these paths as best as I possibly can. I'm not going to be exact. I'm not going to be super accurate. But I want to flesh it out as much as I can. For example, there's an outdoor rink, skating rink, right? So I don't have one of those in UGC currently. Wink, wink, content creators. If you can create one, that'd be awesome. But just placeholders in a sense of making sure that all the paths connect. And again, I'm using 6 squares out of the park right now. Only have 3 more, so I can't even build all of Central Park in 9 squares. It's just too big. It's just not going to happen. So before I do continue and carry on here, I'm actually going to scroll chat just a little bit to see if I missed any questions. And I was actually down here, so I'm going to just tilt it a little bit. I had it, so I have my reference. Sorry, tilting the actual game this way you can. Now I have Google Maps open on the left hand side of my other monitor, so you're going to see me referencing back and forth to just making sure I'm matching up paths and stuff like that. It's going to be a tough one, but I'm going to work through it. So, scrolling chat real quick. What did I miss? Dr. Palooza saying, great, my country is not on the list. Doc, we had a huge list of so many different parks that we were going to go ahead and use references for. It was just entirely way too much. So we picked a bunch of huge locales in terms of where we were looking to spread information. You'll notice that there was a bunch of social that went out from the Netherlands today, from Germany today, here in the US as well, and a bunch of other areas around the globe. To help launch the contest. So I apologize. It's not intended to offend anyone if we missed your country. It's just the list was huge. So over time, there's going to be more contests, and there's a very, very good chance that we're going to do more regional-specific contests. We want to do things like scavenger hunts. We want to do additional park recreations. We want to do coaster contests. We're going to do UGC contests. There's going to be a whole bunch of other stuff coming down the line. If you've been following us on streams, we've mentioned this before. This is just the beginning. We want to do more. Yeah. Sandbox and chill. Oh, we're drinking games now? I missed all these. Oh, Death was trying to link something. Totally missed that, too. Hopefully, looks like JMR got it. Yep. Linking excerpts from the official rules. That's great, JMR. I appreciate that. For those just joining, JMR is Jordan M. Richards, or I like to call him JM Rock. He does really exquisite rock work in RCTW on all his streams. Yeah, I know. Imagineering is a Disney term. I know. I shouldn't be using that term at all. I love the word, though. But let's see. Revisioning. A creative vision. Let's use that instead, right? Death Tomed. Just do it. Oh, I'm just doing it, all right. You're going to watch as much as you can allow on the map. And I was, and I'm glad you mentioned that, Death, because in the last stream, somebody mentioned the same thing. Like, you're not going to be able to fit the whole thing in one game, one park save, right? So I'm going to go through, I think, if it's an ambitious thing to do, but I'm thinking of going through and working on making sections. So I'll make, for example, Central Park Part 1, Part 2, Part 3, and go through and connect all of the sections. Because again, I'll pull up the map for you guys again really, really quick. You know, if you're looking, okay, so for example, this, let's do this. First and foremost, you see, look, here's RCT, right? I got three squares left, and I've only created this northeastern part of the park. So now, if I'm going to come out of park expansion and zoom back in and bring up the maps, and let's go ahead and zoom out and see, okay, that's just this little square right here, okay? This top, like, essentially think about it being, okay, it ends just about here, this double, this Adam Clayton Boulevard over here, West 110th. Kind of ends right there and comes all the way across. So you're thinking like this chunk right here is all I'm going to be able to fit in this one park save, right? But then if you zoom out, Central Park is huge. Look at how big this thing is. There's no way you would get all of this into one park save. It's not going to happen. And then, of course, there's Central Park Zoo. That's all the way down in the southeastern corner. There's a ton of stuff. There is a ton. So, essentially, I like it. There's a nice, peaceful part of the park up here. I've actually been there a number of times. And I was thinking about doing something special. If I did not mention it already, and if I did, forgive me. Question, JMR, how long should the video last? We want the video to be no longer than 3 minutes. And that should be stated in the official contest rules. Just do a fly-through, you know, make something nice, do a couple of crossovers, right? You do from one corner to the other corner. You don't have to do these intricate fly-throughs. Whatever you can fit into 3 minutes to fully show your park to its fullest potential. That's what we're looking to do. So again, the other special thing that I had mentioned in the other stream was a Facebook live stream or a Periscope of this actual location. How many of you out there in chat right now would like to see me walk through Central Park, the actual area that I am creating in the game right now? Something I've been thinking about doing for a while with this contest, and I'm just curious. Death Dome optimization, yeah. All right. Questions, I'm looking. What do you want the UGC makes? Yeah, Death Tome, there's a bunch of stuff. I'm not sure. Well, we can talk off stream. Just because there's a lot of different things that you can... Sorry, multiple modes of communication today. My family is all over the place because we're... Again, it's a U.S. holiday this weekend, so we're closed Monday. I'm trying to collaborate and organize with the family across a couple states to have some barbecue action. Hopefully stay nice and sunny. Everybody, all the families and children could be running around all day. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be great times. Love it. Yes. Out of the office, go in the park. Show. Yeah, Abidi, yes, you were here at the last stream. Cool. Magician, I don't think it would take a long time to show. To be honest with you, I wouldn't show me leaving the office and going there. I would go live in the park and maybe do a half an hour. I would plan out the route on maps to go through to see how long the walking would take. Maybe like a half an hour. Maybe. I don't want to do an hour. I think that would be way too long. So 30 minutes, walk through the park. So key locations, specifically, I'm still showing you the map here on the stream. So maybe come across and actually show you the Lasker Rink right here, what it looks like. And that was the specific UGC reference I was talking about that time. That's a huge request. So the East 110th Street Playground, Charles A. Dana Discovery Center, and I'm talking and tripping all over myself today. I cannot speak. Duke Ellington statue over here on the actual, really up at the top of the corner. But I just thought it was something different. You guys see me sitting in this chair all the time. I think it'd be really cool to go out into Central Park, something live, something organic. Anything could happen. I'm out, bird come fly by, poop on my head. Hilarious, right? Wouldn't you guys love that? I mean, I'm being crazy right now. But at the same time, I just think it'd be something different, something cool to watch. So again, Death Dome wants me to stream from Central Park. Stream to the lot. Okay, good. I'm digging it. I'm digging it. Okay, Comus asking, do the video quality cut affects music count or the park stuff? The video quality is not really going to matter. Some people are going to have more powerful computers than others, so they're not going to be able to record in 1080p, for example. So we are not really going to take into account how good of quality the video is. It does help when we're looking at the park, but it's not going to be a true criteria. Like, we're going to really try to do our best to look through. If you have a lower end machine and you're trying to get the video up, make a note when you send us the email with the video. Your specs would help. I'm not going to ask you to post specs with your entry, but at the same time, it would help to know what you're running on this way. It kind of gives us a little bit of a heads up on why the video quality is maybe lower than some of the other video entries as well. Going through, looking to see. Other questions here. Look a panda. Hello, welcome. Good to see you. And that's the other thing too here, guys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. I mentioned at the beginning of the stream we're doing something special. We're actually multi-streaming right now. I'm streaming on Twitch and Hitbox now at the same time. So LookaPanda is not in the Twitch channel, but over in Hitbox channel. So you may hear me cross-naming back and forth, looking for somebody in chat that's not there. Wave of the future. I told you it's coming. Death, if you do that specific piece, that would be amazing. I can't enter the contest, so I would rather you make the piece for everybody else to maybe possibly use for Central Park, or some other parks as well. I think that'd be really cool. But at the same time, like I said, I'm not going to enter the contest. It'd be cool to have it, but only if it gets turned into a meme. All right, we can talk. We can talk turkey later, and that's fine. So essentially, I want to go through and. You know what? It looks like I'm running down to the end of the park here. So let's just do this. Let's actually go through and buy out all the other squares so it's a full open park. Come out, and I'm actually going to go through and save it. For those of you that are new to the game, many people have asked about autosave. The devs have heard you loud and clear, but in the meantime, until that comes, save your game often. I always do. Those that watch the stream weekly will tell you I save religiously. So now that we have the full open, good. That actually does help a little bit. It opens it up down at the bottom so I can, and again, you'll see my head off over to the left here looking at the actual Google Maps. Go through. Okay, so what did I miss up top here? I missed a mid connector. And there's actually, you know what? Because there's kind of like a circle or a roundabout that's up in the top corner of this park, I'm actually going to go and try and create a little bit of a hook to simulate that roundabout or circle, if you will. I never trust auto Abidi, I never trust autosave on any of my games. I actually leave it alone, let it do its autosave thing on all the games that I play, but always create a manual save every time, always. So asphalt, we want large size, and we want curved. And let's see, let's just do. Let me. Let's back it out just a little bit more, just so I have some room. One more time. That's fine. It's perfect. Again, curved all the way up. So now, again, I'm not looking for perfection here. This is my creative interpretation. And it's just for a reference in terms of trying to keep it on point of All right, there it goes, and it's not getting, because it's curve path. Let's go put back on straight. And you're really, it's been doing that to me. Has anybody else been seeing that when you're switching back and forth between curve path and straight path? Actually, have to come out of paths and go back in order for it to stick. There we go. So while it's not exact, I'm actually going to show you. I'm going to zoom in on the matte piece over here. This way you can kind of get a little bit of a better look. This right here is what I'm looking at. This Duke Ellington square, how it splits and connects right at the edge. Again, it's not perfect by any means. I'm not looking for an exact recreation here, but just as a reference, it does connect over into the corner. And then the next one is right here by the Discovery Center. I'm going to run that up north. I'm going to do another connection over here. So let's go back over into the game. And it's kind of in the center. Not exactly, a little bit. Let's go ahead and just run it up and then one. Connect it into the center so you can see it. There we go. And then once we get down to the bottom, we got a bunch of intertwining paths on the inside here that are going to be a little time consuming. So I'm going to go ahead and take those. And then once we get down here, there's a really cool, I actually want to show you guys. Down here is going to be tough because there is, they call it the conservatory garden. And there are two really cool fountains in the garden. And I'm going to I'll show you the Google Earth view of it because it looks really, really cool. It's got paving in it and shrubs that all go through it and create the pattern. It's really, really cool. I'll show you in just a minute. If you want to scroll chat. Just for me, love it. Now you just need to get your sheet. Okay, that I'm glad you mentioned that, Death. Right now we're using a service called Switchboard, Joycaster, right? So it has YouTube, Twitch, Hitbox, StreamUp, Beam.pro, Dailymotion, StreamSpot, and Ustream. So all of those streaming platforms you can stream to at once, which is insanity, absolute insanity. How am I going to manage that many chats? I don't know, whatever. But bit by bit, so we're using Twitch and Hitbox right now, and then I'm going to go ahead and try and add slowly to them. I'm going to put YouTube on there as well. This way it's getting broadcast across all of them. I'm still saving the local copy of the actual stream itself so that I can render it into a better quality and do overlays if I want, or fade-ins, fade-outs, and then archive them up on YouTube. And I have been slacking on those. I got to get up the previous week's Sandbox and Chill, and the actual dev stream too. I've been prepping and planning for this contest. It's been absolute insanity. So we'll get those up there. But again, I wanted to jump over to the actual map to show you Google Earth. See, so this is basically the bottom half of where the lake comes down, or the mirror, so to speak. It ends here, and then you have the pathing, and then it comes into this conservatory garden. Now, it looks very plain here on the Google Maps view, but when you go Google Earth, look at that. You kidding me? And I love the 3D version, but I'm not going to do it. I'm just going to rotate it a little bit. See that? These two specific fountains on either side, Burnett Fountain and Untermeyer. Vanderbilt Gate is right there, of course, off Fifth Ave. But that would be really cool. You can see, it's kind of hard to see, but you see like these hedges are huge. Like, we don't have hedges that big in the game right now. But it'd be cool to try and make specific paths that go around and hedges. They actually come down. And you can't really get a good view. So let's try and do a little bit of this. Let's go drop the little guy down. And it's kind of sunken down in. Now, I know, Jordan, you're out there. You've done quite a couple of parks. And I've actually watched you do terrain deformation on levels and levels. And you actually did it when we came out to PC Gamer Weekender. We actually met in person. So that would be cool to just do something like that, because you can see how these are leveled off. You can do the different shrubs on each of the levels. It's got a fountain in the middle. I mean, we have those. You can create, essentially what I would do is I would create a terrain deformation in the middle and then put some of those UGC with the floating fountains on the inside. Maybe not one, because it might not be big enough. Maybe put a couple, but I thought that would be cool. So you go through and you look and you can see one of the UGC pieces that I haven't seen yet, facades. I know I think it was Menschmeyer that did a bunch of stuff for Holland, like Holland storefronts and kind of like UGC piece by piece stuff. New York City facades, to be able to look up and see all the different areas around. Like, this is a bad example because it's up at the northern end. But if we actually went back to the map, we come zoom out, and we come all the way down, get some of the actual, like, for example, if we come down, there's Sheet Meadow. Is it? That's Hesher Field. We come up. Great Lawn, I think, is a good place. Let's try it. If you come drop yourself in the middle of the Great Lawn. Oh, this is a picture taken from winter. Oh, that's lovely. Thank you, Google. But you see the skyline in the background? I think it'd be really cool to have some really tall buildings and city skylines in there as well. And I'm actually going to drop. I'm going to come down a little bit, come past the lake, and I'm going to drop on the west side of Central Park. Strawberry Fields forever. Yeah, I won't sing anymore, I promise. Come on, there's got to be a spot. Put me right there. Be like, and to be now, how cool would it be if I was wandering through this live? Not this part, but cool little bridge. It's like you're not even in the city. You can't even see any of the buildings. You can see some tall buildings on the side, tall enough to poke out over. But again, I digress. Back to the map. Let's do a quick refresh so all the crosses come out. There we go. And we'll come back up to the mirror. Harlem Mir. I'm going to continue working on this a little bit. I thought it'd be cool to show you guys that specific piece of the park, because those two fountains with the gardens right in the center would be something really cool to make. All right, so let's quick chat scroll here. It's about a little bit after 3:30. I do want to continue building a little bit. I may go over an hour. I'm not entirely sure yet. We'll see how I feel. I said I got to get those renders up and done for the archives. I'm slacking on those. I need to. Why are you slacking? Death, I hear you. I see you. So PFC saying, can you please tell the devs to move the UGC window up on my 1080p laptop? The window hangs under the bottom of my screen. Have you reported that over on the thread yet, PFC? That's something I'm sure they want to see. And I'm just taking a note, as I always do, right? Notebook. 1080p UGC UI. Off. Okay. Multiple modes of communication again. Oh my goodness. Yes, I know. Yes, I know. Okay. Well, the questions here over in chat allow us to move the window. Okay, cool. Yeah, I took that note, PFC. It almost sounds like you're moving in game while moving the Google Maps. Yeah, I think I'm good like that sometimes. Full screen bug. I'll be playing and walk away, and my computer goes into standby because Windows doesn't pick up the fact that I have RCTW open. Okay. Standby mode. Making notes like I always do. Not recognizing. I know that's a really good song. I'm not going to sing because I will ruin it for you. I don't have it on in the background, so I can't match pitch and tone and key, so we're not going to do that. All right, so again, back to building, right? It's not going to be an exact recreation. I want it to be as close as possible, but it's not going to be perfect, which is okay because this is a creative vision, my particular creative vision. I'm excited to see what your visions are. There's actually too far, so let's zoom in, flatten that out. There we go. Now let's go back straight. I want to come down straight a little bit because there's actually, it's not, it comes up. There's a little triangle right there. And it actually loops around. This thing gets crazy. All the paths that connect are awesome. But at the same time, it's like insanity trying to replicate this. Challenge accepted. I don't want to go too far down. So, down. That's actually pretty straight. So to be on the level, let's just go... How much more room do I have? I got a bunch more room. So let's just come down here. If I need to do curves, we can do curves at a later date and time. So now there's one specific piece that comes out. And now, I'm going to try and use curves to the best of my ability. Again, gentle. Actually, not a perfect circle, it's more of like an oval. A little bit higher. Oh, that's close. Oh, that's real close. This way. See, and it keeps switching. Has it been doing that for anyone? Switching back and forth between straight and curved? He's done that to me a few times today. Look around it, just delete it. Make sure you're on it. Now I want to try and get it as square as possible. You know what, let's come down from this side first. That's too far. I think that's going to be close enough for purposes here. So now, let's do this one. It's actually, it's not too bad. That's actually a little bit too far. It's a little bit better. No, that's not enough. I think that's going to do it for now. Let's go back to straight because there's one piece that's almost on, immediately on the other side that comes out. And then that one hooks around. Let's do this one like this. Here. Now this one will, actually this one curves a little bit. So we'll go ahead and switch over to curved. I'm going to put the music back on in just a minute because it's awfully quiet. And let's actually save it too. While we're in the menu, save. Harlem Mirror. Right. Yes, please. Thank you. And let's go back into music. Ah, much better. I'm going to get some more call outs in chat here. Resume. The Killamon asking, if we choose to go for the open option in the contest, can we recreate a theme park? Absolutely. The only thing you want to try to remember in the actual official rules is stay away from things that are trademarked, copywritten, illegal, or anything like that, just to be on the safe side. But again, if it's your essentially the open category is just that, it's open. You're free to use whatever UGC in-game content you want to build the park. And we're not going to be looking for any specific location references like Central Park or Hyde Park or English Gardens or anything like that. What else do we got? Yeah, JMR, doing the curvature after you place it. Yeah, that would be crazy. I think that's what you're saying, right? Yeah, the curve one, it's a Bevier curve right now, so it's based on... 3 points, your starting point, midpoint, end point, and then it bends it as you pull it and turn it, tweak it, so. Oh, okay, so talking about, yeah, the actual bug we were just talking about. Okay, Death has had that. So a couple of people have had that. Have you guys, I'm not looking at those, I'm sorry, the EA, the early access trackers, the bug trackers. I'm not heavily looking at those every day. I know the dev team is, but if you have not put it up there, please definitely put it up over there too. They should definitely see that. So let's go ahead and finish connecting. Let's go pull back. It's just a small piece. And then let's do more curved. Actually, just a little bit. See, did it again. Fine. Work with it. Work around it. Watch. So it comes here, and then... And I'm going to shoot in just a minute. And that's actually just in order to... Because there's a fountain in the middle of it, so let's do that. So, on the top of this point, it's back into pads. Okay, so that one goes there, that one goes there. And then it kind of just, it's all open over here, so it comes off. Straight. Right about there. Now we're going to go back to curved. Those. Actually too much. Yeah, that's actually too much. I need to bring that back. All the way back. There we go. Back to pads. To curve, just because we can. It does kind of come out. And it's actually... That's not even, I don't even think that's... I might get away with it. There's actually another big winding, this piece here. This road actually winds down. And then, because the rink is over here, it kind of, and actually, you know what? That might be a better form of reference to do. So, I'll show you. I'm going to pull up the map for you guys right now. So you see, I'm working on. Let's look. Let's zoom in on the actual Untermeyer fountain that I was just working on to kind of get a feel for what I'm looking at versus what the maps is looking at. So there's maps. There's in-game. Now it's not exact, but I think it's pretty darn close. Mine is much more of an oval shape than the actual path itself, but you get the general idea. Of what I'm trying to do here. Not an exact recreation, it's a creative vision. So back on to Google Maps just to look. I was talking about this East Drive, as you can see. East Drive winds down past the initial piece of the lake and it comes down around Lasker Rink. So I'm thinking I might take and stretch that all the way around so I can use that as a reference point when I'm trying to build the other paths through. That might not be a bad idea. So let's pull this out. I'm back in game. Bring you guys with me. There we go. So that's this piece over here that I was talking about. So if I come up and just do mid, it looks like it comes out a little bit too far. So if we come back in, tighten this up a little bit. All right. But I do want to do one quick thing. Save. There we go. Beautiful. Zoom. So, trying to line it up. Oh, another shout out. JMR. Be cool if there was a prize for the best park-related UGC for one of the parks. To encourage UGC creators to share their park-specific creations, like Ice Rink, for instance. Otherwise, I fear that most of the good park-related UGC will be kept private. Yeah, I think it's a good incentive. I'm definitely going to be running a UGC contest specifically, so... That is going to challenge all of our modelers and content creators out there. I think that's going to be a cool one. I'm just scrolling chat real quick. Okay, no other questions. Good. So let's get back to building. We're about 10 minutes out from 4 o'clock. Probably end up keeping it to an hour because I have to render out those other archives to get them done and up. And slacking. Why are you guys letting me slack? Chat. You guys let me. Yell at me. Tell me. Do something. So, back to my paths. We're on mid. I think I may have... Yeah, that's actually... That's way too far. So let's go, let's actually bring it back up a whole bunch more to where it crosses. Right at the edge, just like that. Perfect. So again, make sure I'm on curved. This way I can come in a little bit, but even though it doesn't curve that way, actually bring it like this. Help. But it ends, start it right there. Go. Something like that. Yes. How close? There's actually a really big gap, so it doesn't. A little bit of a bend. Like that, and then it comes back. This way, actually. Back, that's too much. Back this way and connects. There's actually another connector over here. Straight, back to the straight edge. Thank you, straight path. I see you, chat. I see you. Give me just a minute. So it comes down and then back to curved. Because it actually crosses out this way a little bit. Does it cross 102nd Street crossing? And then it comes down. And we're almost at the end of the park size, so I'm just gonna run it. That angle's too steep. A little bit of a curve. Right like that. And now you have the big winding piece. It's not exact, of course, but here's what the map looks like. Right? There's the map. Zoom in just a little bit. Got the S curve. There's a couple other pieces in there to put, but there's a map. RCT. Map, RCT. I think that's a good comparison to show you guys. One more time, as I always do, save and save. And I saw chat scrolling, so. Magician yelling at me, do something, yes. Does a little dance. Does that count? No, Sylvester, your dance does not count because I did not actually see it. Pick or it didn't happen. Looking. What else you got? Nah, I don't need any assistance in the background, faceless. Male or female, doesn't matter. I'm good. Got my nice big canteen of water right here. If I'm thirsty, good to go. I come prepared. I think. Any more questions? Loser Dude, Vape Nation. Welcome to the chat, Loser Dude. My wife would not do it. She does not work with me. All right, so question's looking good. Talking about making her Six Flags. That'd be cool. Again, just be careful of what you're using. Nice Sims. Aww, we already have a great guy streaming. No need for assistance. Nothing but love. That's what I'm talking about. Even though it's going to be a great long weekend, you guys just made my weekend. That was awesome. So, now back to in-game. I'm going to pull up the map really quick. Again, we're closing in here on the hour. I think I am going to cut it at the hour. We got our S-curve. We're looking pretty good. I'm thinking I might just, instead of actually putting the rink, I may end up putting some plazas in there. But there's still a ton of different paths to connect. So, there's actually some really cool dirt paths that run through there that I'm going to try and put in. Yeah, there's a bunch. There's quite a bunch. All these cross paths here between Fort Clinton and Nutter's Battery. Yeah. Think that's going to be a challenge, but you know what? Challenge accepted. Even though I'm not eligible for the contest, that's fine. That's fine. But again, being able to put in whatever you want, you know, when we talk about the different categories, we're looking for the criteria. of the specific reference. For example, Central Park, we're looking for references for Central Park, the specific baseball fields, or Harlem Mere, like I'm using, or another small lake, or a fountain, or an archway, or a specific monument. You want to create it in UGC, create it, throw it in there. I mean, the sky's the limit with this stuff, so definitely, definitely use it. And again, these are going to now evolve through Sandbox and Chill. So I know we were working on the Adventure Theme one, as much as I love it. Really going to take and use this specific park to share what I'm working on to help inspire you to create parks of greatness around the world. Enter them into that contest. Really cool giveaways. I want to make sure I'm not missing any questions. At a BDS, can we hope for a park inspector? That would be nice. An additional staff member outside of what we already have. JMR, yes. That's exactly what we're talking about. Use your own vision to create a park with references from Central Park. So the layout could be a little bit different. Like, for example, you could have, you know, one of the other options, ideas, you could have this, say you want to use my example and go to that specific piece of the park and use Mirror Lake. You can do whatever you want. I mean, like, if you want to take and make, let's see if it works, see if the game works with me now. Let's just do a straight path, and we want small bridges. Connect bridges all the way across if you want, right? See if I can get lucky, all the way across. Right, so you got these footpaths where the peeps can go all the way across. Let's see if we can get real lucky now. Not gonna do it. Oh! Saw it. I saw it. Saw it. Come on. It's not gonna let me. It's being so temperamental. But, alright, for that one. So, I mean, you can build walkways across the entire pond so all your peeps can go back and forth. Put fountains. I mean, sky's the limit. Whatever layout you want to do, what we're really looking for is when you pick your reference, make it noticeable. Like, if you're going to pick a statue or a fountain or specifically the conservatory gardens right down below, I'm going to go back to GMAPS once again and pull on Earth and show you guys. See that? That's what I'm talking about. I don't know why it does that either, but here, to make it zooming in again, to be able to see all these different things, and I'm behind my face chat. Face cam, getting in the way. That would be awesome. But again, to do anything like in the in-game, like I was placing them and had maps up and totally not showing you what I was placing, but I essentially went through and just made connectors all over the lake. So you're coming all the way across. So whatever layout you want, right? I actually think that's pretty cool. And then this is what I was trying to do here. The maps up, not showing you. This way, you got walkways all over. It's your own creative vision, whatever you want. Death Tome, is that a GTX 1080 in the background we see? No, that is not a 1080. That's an old 900 series. I'm not sure which one. What is that? I think it's a 980, yeah. So, coming up here on 4 o'clock. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go ahead and put a bunch of links in chat for you guys this way. This way you guys can see where the official rules are one more time. I did minimize it. See, up, down. Now we're back into the game. So that link is the official contest rules. Have a look at those. If you do have any questions, you know where you can message me. You guys follow the stream and you follow me. It's just, you know where I am. For those that don't, here on Twitch, over on Hitbox, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Steam, our forums. I mean, I'm all over the place. So if you got me as a friend on Steam, you want to message me there, that's fine. You want to send me a message here, DM on Twitter, wherever. Just don't be afraid to ask questions. I'm going to try and field the questions too when we actually have Sandbox and Chill and I'm using this park to create more. And this is not going to take away from the actual dev streams that we normally do. When the patch is coming, I like to be able to show you all what is coming before you get it. I think that's kind of cool. And then when it goes live later on that week, you guys get it and play it. The stream numbers are down significantly, but that's a good thing because you guys are playing the game, which is awesome. But again, playing with you through all of the updates and content additions, the ups and downs, right? We all play through it. Early access, right? Anything can happen. Trying to come at you with consistent patches to make sure that we're addressing issues in the game. For those of you, pound, optimize, hashtag optimize. And I keep saying pound because I'm old school, all right? I was around before hashtags were around, so that symbol is not a hashtag for me, it's the pound sign. Anyway, the other link I wanted to put here for you guys is the actual email address. Streamers@rollercoastertycoon.com. Be sure you check the official rules for the subject lines. Make sure that those are correct, because the subject lines are really going to matter when it comes down to putting your entries of how we're looking at them. And I can go ahead, I'm going to link those for you guys really quick here in the chat, just so you have them. Those are the different, and they're, the actual subject line is in the quotes. You'll see RCTW Park Creation Contest is in all of them. And the first category is open. Second category is US. Third category, UK. Fourth category is NL for the Netherlands. And fifth category is DE for Germany. So definitely look at those. Pound sign, hash, Sylvester. No. I did. We'll agree to disagree. How does that sound? So prizes. Sims, if you missed it, I mentioned at the beginning. Essentially, we're going to have four winners for each category for a total of 20 winners. Grand prize, first prize, second prize, third prize. So grand prize winners are going to get a $200 Amazon gift card and one of these. As you can see, that lovely RCT t-shirt. I am not a model by any means, but this is one of the shirts that you're going to get. The first runner-up is going to get a $100 gift card to Amazon and a t-shirt. Second runner-up is going to get a $50 Amazon gift card and a t-shirt. And then the third runner-up is going to get a $25 gift card to Amazon. So, yeah, blue shirts. Yes, absolutely. Funky t-shirt as modeled by Nook. Yes, I am nowhere near a fashion model. Although I did shave and clean myself up for the stream today. So, yeah, I'm going to be sending out those t-shirts. Optimize. You still got to get that zoom effect. So, posters one day. Yeah, we're hoping to get those. I'm not sure if we've ordered those, but posters would be cool. We want to give away a bunch of stuff. I mean, there's some really big prizes we've been talking about. And I mean, you know, the think tank gets together and we just spew ideas up onto the whiteboard and mark them all down. So we keep a running list and so we know what we've thought about in the past and we're not trying to recreate the wheel every time we do it. So there's going to be a lot of cool stuff. Luke is the best modeler for that shirt. Oh, Death Tome. You're so sweet. Appreciate that. So I think we're going to wrap it up here, folks. Again, like I said, if you guys are new to the stream, follow us here at Twitch, over on Hitbox, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Steam, our forums. We're going to be increasing our footprint in terms of stream platforms. The mainstay for us right now is Twitch. That's where we get most of the viewership. We're on Hitbox right now doing some dual streaming, which is really, really cool. But we're going to be adding YouTube streams. Ustream is another possibility. Beam.pro is another one. StreamUp. I mean, there's so many platforms out there now for streamers to get their message out, get their vision out. And, yeah, hopefully. Miski, welcome to the end of the stream. Just to loop you in, we launched a contest today. Giving away some really cool prizes. I'll recirculate the actual contest rules for you. Death Tome, signing of the t-shirts. I cannot confirm nor deny that we will have signed t-shirts. That'd be really cool. Next time one of us goes there, please. Listen, there's more coming. Trust me. Signed t-shirts was one request by many people, which I think would be really, really cool. Yeah, I just had a total blank out, staring blankly and looking at scrolling through chat to see if there are any other questions. Essentially, that's it. Misky, like I said, we launched the contest. We're giving away a bunch of cool stuff. It's going to run for an entire month. It opens today. The contest closes at 11:59 p.m. on June 26th. The prizes are going to be Amazon gift cards and t-shirts across the board with all the different categories. So I am going to... Yeah, you're asking me to sign the grand prize t-shirts. I know. Since when have I been working on RCTW? I came on board came on board back in February. Beginning of February. So, I am the new guy on the team. Yes, absolutely. Some of the other seasoned veterans here on the team have been in development quite a bit longer than I have. I actually do some other stuff here at a local NYC indie dev scene as well, for those that are in tune with game development and the International Game Developers Association. Really great organization that I work with too. Love doing work with them. So, Baseless, good to see you. Thanks for stopping by. JMR, thanks for seeing you. Thanks for hanging. Everybody else that I miss, Faceless, Abidi, Sims, Death, Sylvester, Misky, thanks for coming in at the very end. I appreciate you hanging. I mean, so many. Killamon, Columbus, Joel. I mean, there's so many of you in here that always come back. Currently, if I miss you, I'm sure you'd probably come out here and punch me. And so many others that I probably miss. I really do appreciate the support. Stay tuned for more. That's going to be coming through in terms of the contest. I'm going to be sharing with you, and I can't wait to see the updates as well. So, again, if you have questions, you know where to reach me. If not, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Twitch, Hitbox, forums, Steam, so many different places. If you haven't added me on Steam, my Steam name, and actually that's a really good point that I'm going to go to here. Typing it in chat right now. That is my Steam ID. Want to add me? I try to answer messages as fast as possible. Sometimes I'm away from my computer. I don't sit in front of it all day. So hit me up. Send me a message. Again, really appreciate you guys hanging and stopping by. Stay tuned for more month-long contests. As like I said, dev streams are going to continue. I'm also going to do more contests after this one. I'm not going to do any with this one. I think it's a little bit too much. So, yeah, I appreciate you guys hanging out. You know where to hit me. Have a good weekend, everybody, and I'll talk to you next week.